This conference will now be recorded.
Right, let's start. So in the last class we discussed about hope my voice is audible. Okay, right. So in the last class we discussed about creating the database tables using what data elements and domains, and we understood that a data element is a reusable dictionary object which provides a description for the field. Okay, and this description will appear at different places wherever the data element is used. And then domain is a reusable dictionary object which provides the technical properties of the field. So in the last class in ABAP dictionary in SE11, we have created one database table Z645 underscore EMB, and this table is a client dependent table. Any table which contains MANDT as a field, first field, we call that table as client dependent table. Okay, and this table has got some five fields including MANDT, and the primary key fields are combination of client field and what employee number. So this is what we have created in the last class. Now in order to maintain this table, we need to create what? We need to generate what? Table maintenance. Okay, so before that we have seen how to generate the table maintenance, and we understood that while generating the table maintenance, we need to provide the authorization group, we need to provide the function group, and we need to what provide the maintenance type. In the last case, we have provided the maintenance type as what? One step. In one step, only one screen will be generated. Now let us see once again how to generate the table maintenance. Before that, we require what? Function group. Okay, already we have created the function group in the last class, but this is a different server. So let me create a function group once again. So where do we create the function group? SE80. Object navigator. So in the object navigator, create the function group so that whenever we generate the table maintenance, some dependent objects gets generated, and those dependent objects get stored as part of table, a function group. Let's open in that object navigator. So in the drop down, I'll choose function group. Let us provide the function group name. I'll give it as something Z645F group. Z645F group is the name of the function group. Z645F group, press enter. Function group does not exist. Create the object, provide the description. Save it. I'll save it in the local object. Function group is created. So before I start using this, let me activate this. Right click on the function group and say activate. Function group will be activated. Done. Now let us go back to the table. So in ABAP dictionary in SE11, let us generate the table maintenance for this particular table. So for that we need to choose utilities table maintenance generator. provide the authorization group. I'll just browse this. I'll give the authorization group as &NC function group. I'll give it as Z645 F group. Z645 F group. I'll press enter. Right, so authorization group is &NC function group is a one we have created, and I'll choose the maintenance type as two step. Okay, in case of last table, you have chosen one step, so only one screen is generated called as what overview screen. Now, in two step, two screens will be generated, one is overview screen and single screen. In overview screen, we can read, delete, and update. In single screen, we can insert the record. Okay, I repeat. In overview screen, we can read, delete, and update. In single screen, we can create the record, insert the record. So I'll choose two step. For these two screens, we have to provide the screen numbers. Let SAP generate the screen number. So on the application toolbar, we have the button find screen numbers. I'll click on that. Propose the screen number. It has proposed something 1 and 2. Click on the create button on the application toolbar. It will generate the table maintenance. So it is generating the table maintenance. Done. So table maintenance is generated. Just save it once, go back, activate your table once again. So the table maintenance is generated. So once a table maintenance is generated, we can maintain the table using the transaction code what SM30. So let us go to SM30 and maintain the table. So I'll go to SM30. In this SM30, here we need to provide the table name. So let me give the table name z645_emp, and we need to click on what maintain button. So when I click on the maintain button, right, so it has opened me the overview screen where we are able to see the existing data. Okay, so in this overview screen, I can view the data, I can delete the data. How do you delete the data? Select the entry. There is a button on the application toolbar, delete button. If I click on the delete button, number of delete entries is what? 1. So let me save it. Then I need to update it. So this is a record. I'll just choose, I can update this, save it. Done, it is saved. If you want to insert the record, I'll click on new entries. I got a new screen. This is called as what? A single screen where we can insert the data. Okay, so before we do this, understood? So we have all the four columns done. Now here, if I go back, so in order to maintain the table, we were using what SM30. Okay, in order to maintain the table, we are using SM30. But again, if you keep end user in mind, we have to minimize the navigation. So for that, what we'll do? For that, we need to provide what? We need to minimize the navigation. So for that, we need to create the T code. When you're creating the T code for this SM30, we need to skip the initial screen. So if you're skipping this screen, somewhere we have to maintain these values. In order to maintain these values, I should know the names of this input field. I should know the function code of the push button. So how do we collect the name of this input field? Put the cursor in there, press F1. Okay, put the cursor in the input field. If you press F1, you'll get a screen like this. Click on the technical information button. Yeah, screen field name is what? View name. View name is the name of that input field. And I need to collect the function code of the maintain button. Okay, so I'll put the focus on the maintain button. Press F1. The function code of the maintain button is what? UPD, which indicates what? Update. Done. So let us create the T code for this. So how do you create the custom T codes? SC93. Okay, so I'll go to SC93. Let me, since it is a custom T code, we have to start with what? GRY. So I'll say Z EMP. Provide some name, start with ZRY. So I gave it a Z EMP. Click on create. Provide the short text. And provide some short text. Done. So we are creating the T code for what? Table maintenance. If you are creating the T code for an executable program, I mean to say, if you are creating the T code for report program, we choose what? Program and what? Selection screen. Now we are creating the T code for a table maintenance. So choose the last radio button, transaction with parameters. Transaction with parameters, continue. Transaction code ZEMP is already existing itself. So let me give the name as something ZEM, ZEM, continue, done. Transaction, for what you are creating the T code? For table maintenance. What is the T code of the table maintenance? SM30 is the T code for table maintenance. So provide the transaction as SM30 and select the checkbox, skip initial screen. I'll select the checkbox skip initial screen because we need to skip the initial screen. Then whenever we create any T code, we need to select the checkbox SAP GA for Windows. Then only we can use the T code. So select the checkbox skip initial screen. Select the checkbox SAP GA for Windows. Since you are skipping the initial screen, we have to provide the values for the fields in that skipped screen. Okay. So what is the name of the screen field we have collected? View name. Okay, view name. Okay, view name. So this field is expecting what? Name of the table. What is the name of our table? Z645 underscore EMP is the name of the table. And then function code. Okay, what is the function code? Update. Update. And you have to set it to what? X, which indicates that the user has clicked on what? Maintain button. UPD indicates what? UPD indicates update. So if I give only UPD, when I try to save, it is give the field UPD does not exist on the called screen. So it is not recognizing that. Okay, it is not recognizing this. If you browse, you can see here it is not UPD, it is what? Update. So I'll choose update. Done. I'll click on save one. Done. So I created the T code for our table maintenance by skipping the initial screen. Since we are skipping the initial screen, we need to provide the values for the fields for which we have to enter the data. Done. So this is the T code. Now we can start maintaining the table by running the T code what? ZEM. So for end user, in the technical specs, we need to provide this particular T code information. Okay, for maintaining the employee data, use so and so T code. So when I run this ZEM, right, it is taking the control to that particular screen, and you can see here I got the label for employee number and employee name, but it didn't got the label heading for what? Employee's designation. I didn't got the label for employee designation. Okay, and you can observe here, this is my overview screen. Right, this is my overview screen. Here I got the headings as employee number, employee name. When I click on new entries, I'll get the single screen. Here you can see the labels are different. Employee number. Understood? This is, I think, short label. This is short label. Okay, so in different screens, it is picking what? Different labels. So if I click on new entries, here I got employee number, employee name, and this I got as plus symbol because we have not maintained any label for that particular designation field. So what is my requirement now? Okay, so if you observe here, let me open the table. So if you go to SC11, in this particular table, yeah, if you see the employee number data element, Z employee underscore number is a data element. If I double click on this, for this data element, Z employee underscore number, if you go to field label, I maintain short, medium, long heading. Okay, so if you observe the overview screen, in the overview screen, I got what employee number, which label it is picking here? It is picking the long label here. Okay, if I go to single screen, if I click on new entries, I got this screen here, it is picking employee number, which label it is picking? Medium label. So in different screens, it is automatically picking what? Different labels. Okay, and if you observe both in overview screen, as well as in the single screen, I got plus symbol here, because if you observe the designation column, I created this by using the data element, but if I double click on this data element, I have not maintained any label for what? I have not maintained a label for this data element. Since I have not maintained the label, I didn't got any what heading for what? Employee salary, both in what? Overview screen, employee designation, both in what? Overview screen, as well as in what? Single screen. Understood? So now my requirement is, I want the heading for what? I want the heading for what? At this employee designation column. So for that, what I'll do, I'll go back to my table where I use this data element. So for employee designation, this is the data element. This is the data element. I'll double click on the data element. Right, I'll double click on the data element employee underscore designation. I'll maintain only one medium label. So I'll choose only what designation, and I'm doing it only for the medium label. Done, save it, activate the data element. Done. Data element is active. Activate the table once. Okay. So what is the change I have done? The sequence of steps is, first we add the data element without what? Label. Without the field, without the label. Then what we did, we have generated what? Table maintenance. So when you generate the table maintenance, what is happening? Okay, heading is not available. Okay, heading is not available for what? EMP designation. Understood? EMP designation. So what I did, now I maintained what? Label for what? Data element of what? Employee designation. So now what I want to check, I want to check, since I maintain the label for employee designation data element, I want to check whether it is reflected my table maintenance or not. So I'll go run the T code ZEM. Right. So I didn't got the label heading. I didn't got the heading for what? Designation in the overview screen. Let me click on new entries. I'll get a single screen now. Here also I didn't got the heading. So what is the meaning? Even though I maintain the label in my data element level, it is not reflecting the existing table maintenance. So what is the understanding? Once you generate the table maintenance, and after generating the table maintenance, if you make any changes to the table, like if you change the labels at data element levels, or if you add the additional fields or delete the existing fields, or if you modify the data types, it will not reflect what? Table maintenance. So for that, what you have to do, we have to adjust your existing table maintenance. We have to what? Change your existing table maintenance, or delete the existing table maintenance and regenerate the table maintenance. I repeat this point. once a table maintenance is generated, after that, if you make any changes to your table structure, like adding additional columns or modifying existing columns or modifying the labels of the fields, those changes will not reflect the existing table maintenance. In order to reflect what you have to do, either we need to change the existing table maintenance or regenerate the table maintenance. Means you have to delete and recreate the table maintenance. So what I'll do now is, already the table maintenance is generated. So let me go back to my table. So what is my agenda here? I have maintained the label for what? This designation column. I have maintained the label for the designation column, but the designation label is not appearing in the table maintenance. So what I'll do, I'll go to the existing table maintenance. How do you navigate to the table maintenance? Choose the menu utilities, table maintenance generator. I'll choose this, open the table either in change mode or what, display mode, doesn't matter. So this is my existing table maintenance, right? I'll open this in the change mode, right? So I'll choose utilities, table maintenance generator. Yeah, this is my table maintenance generator. What is my requirement now? I need to adjust this particular table maintenance. How do you do it now? See, on the application toolbar, there is a change button. I can just click on change and I can regenerate, or I can delete and recreate. Okay, so I'll go for this approach now. What is this? Change on the application toolbar. I'll click on the change button. That is asking reason for change. What is the reason for change? We have done some changes to the table. What changes? I have added the label at the data element level. Okay, it can be any reason. Just select everything. Just select everything. Just select everything. Select all the checkboxes, continue. The maintenance type has not yet been changed. Continue. Okay, so what is the maintenance type I've chosen? Two step means overview screen and what? Single screen. So I'll just choose overview screen and what? Single screen. This I don't require. Just select the overview screen and what? Single screen. Continue. Maintenance screen 1 will be deleted and recreated. No problem. Continue. Maintenance screen 2 will be deleted and recreated. Continue. So just clicked on what? Change button. It is showing the checkboxes. Select all the checkboxes and say what? Continue. So it is going to what? Recreate the table maintenance. So request completed without error. So let me just save it once, go back, activate your table once. So what I have to do now, I need to check whether it is reflected the table maintenance or not. So I'll run the T code, what, ZEM. Then you can see now I got the label here. I got the label for designation. This in the overview screen. Let me click on new entries. Even in the new entries also, I got the label. Okay, I maintain only medium label for the designation data element. So the same label is appearing in what? Overview screen as well as in what? Single screen. So what is the meaning of that? It's not compulsory that I have to maintain all the labels. Even if you maintain one label, the same label will be appearing in what? Different types of screens. Okay, if you maintain different labels, in each screen, SAP will pick up a different label, either short, medium, long, or what? Heading. So done. I got the designation heading here. Okay. Done. Now what I'll do is, so what is the understanding now? Understanding is, whenever we make the changes to the table, like, okay, first let me do that, then I'll repeat that point. So my requirement now is, my table as of now contains how many fields? Some 5 fields. So to this existing table, I want to add some 2 additional fields. Okay, to this existing field, to this existing table, I want to add some 2 additional fields. So how you can add, since it is a custom table, I can directly open the table in the change mode. I can keep on adding the fields. I can keep on adding the fields. But my requirement is, I want to add two fields. Okay, I want to add two fields like joining date and what? Joining time. Try to understand. I want to add two fields, joining date and joining time. But what I want is, I want to reuse these fields in the sense, the same fields, I want to add in multiple dictionary objects. I want to add in multiple tables or multiple structures. So what I can do is, one way is directly I can open the table and add those two fields like J date and what? J time I can add. But my requirement is what? The same fields I want to add in what? Other tables also or other structures also. So what I'll do now is, instead of adding them as individual fields, I will create them as part of what? Database structure. I'll create them as part of what? Dictionary structure. Understood? So already we know how to create structure in our programs. Structure is nothing but what? Work area. We know how to create the work area in the program level. Okay, so that is local to the program. But now I am creating the structure at what? Database level. So we call it as dictionary structure. It is reusable. Once a dictionary structure is available, I can reuse it in other dictionary structure, or I can reuse it in other repository objects. So my requirement is, I want to create a structure, dictionary structure, with how many fields? Two fields. And I want to, I can include this structure in any number of repository objects and any number of what? Dictionary objects. So when you're creating the structure fields, again, same thing. I can create the fields either by using direct data types, or I can create these fields by using what? Data elements and what? Domain. So what I'll do now is, let me create those two fields by using what? Data elements and domains. So how do you create the structure? Same in ABAP dictionary, in SC11. You have to choose what? Data type. So my agenda is what? I want to create a dictionary structure, database structure, so that I can reuse it in what? N number of repository objects and N number of dictionary objects. So since it is my custom structure, right, I'll use what? Z. If you remember, already we have seen some standard structures, like in internal tables, we discussed a structure called a screen structure. This screen is a structure given by what? SAP itself. So it's a structure, nothing but work area. Right? So I want to create what? My own structure. So I'll give Z. I'll give the name of the structure as something ZJ details, something Z joining detail. So in understood, in SC11, choose the radio button data type and provide the structure name. I'll click on create. So it is going to ask you whether you want to create a data element or a structure or a table type. Already we know the meaning of data element. Data element provides what? Description for the field. But now I want to create what? Structure. So I'll choose the radio button, what? Structure. Continue. Done. Provide the short description. The fields in the structure, we call it as what? Components. The fields in the structure, we call it as component. So this is the component here. So what are the components I want to declare, like joining date and what? Joining time. So I'll give the field name as joining date. Then here I'll choose types. And here you can see it is asking component type, nothing but data element. Okay, here also just like table, structure fields also I can create by using direct data type, or I can create by using what? Data elements and what? Domains. If you want to create by using direct data, what you will do, this column has to be enabled. So I'll click on what? Predefined type. Here we need to provide what? Data type name. Okay, so I can browse this. Okay, so in your program level, if you want to declare any date variable, how do you declare? You'll say data x type d. Okay, for declaring time, You will say data something y type t indicates what? Time. Date and what? Time. Date and time. So here I want to store what? Date in this particular field. So what I'll do, I'll choose the data type as browsers. Okay, I'll choose what? Dats. Date field. Stored as what? Character of it 8. What is the format? Year, month and date it seems. So when I choose this, when I press enter, I got the length as what? 8. Similarly, I'll choose another, I'll create another field, J time types. What is the data element you want to give? Time. So if you browse this, for time we have a field called as TMS, hours, minutes, seconds, stored as character of 6. So I can choose like this. Okay, understood. So I can create the structure fields by using what? Direct data types. But already always it is recommended to create the table fields or structure fields by using what? Data elements and domains, because they are reusable and we can maintain the descriptions for those fields. So anyhow, we know this part. Let me remove this. So what is my requirement here? I want to create the structure fields by referring to what? Data elements and what? Domains. By creating data elements and domains. Okay, so for that reason I'll click on what? Component type, so that this will be enabled. Here I need to give what? Data element name. I need to give the data element name. Okay. So so in the last class, what you have done, when you have created the table for those fields, for those table fields, we have created our own data elements. So here also I can create my own data elements referring to our date and time data types. Instead of we creating the data elements once again, I want to make use of the standard data element given by what? SAP. So what SAP has done is, for storing the date, they gave one data element called as DATUM. DATUM. So it is not starting with Z or Y. So you have to understand that is what? It's a standard data element given by SAP. So when I press enter, you can see here I got the data type and what? Length. Understood? So if I double click on this data element, datum, if I double click on this, you can see this is a data element given by SAP, which has got some field label. For all, they maintained some three labels here, short, medium and long. And this data element they created by referring to a domain. Okay, domain stores what? Technical properties of the field, like data type and what? Size. Data type and size. Okay, so I can make use of the data element given by SAP. Here also, for time, we have one data element called as UGIT. What is the time? Data type I got? Time and what? 6. TMS of what? 6. Done. So I created my structure with what? 2 fields. If you want, you can create what? Our own data element. Suppose I'll give here Z something time. Okay, I'll press enter. When I press enter, it is there. Might be it is already available. So I'll give something Z times. I'll press enter. It is not available. So what you have to do? Create the data element. While creating the data element, first you need to create the domain, activate the domain, come back and maintain the label in your data element level and activate your data element. But instead of creating once again, I'll make use of the standard data element given by SAP itself. Done. Clear? Okay. Let me save it now. Check for the syntax error. When I do syntax check, I got some warnings. Enhancement category is what? Missing. So just like for database tables also, we must specify what? Enhancement category. Similarly, for your database structures also, we have to provide the enhancement category. Where do you provide? You'll choose. Extras. Enhancement category. Okay, the structure is not classified. Select an enhancement category. Right, so these are the available enhancement categories. I'll go for what? Can be enhanced with character type or numeric. What is the meaning of that? In future, I can add the fields whose data type should be either character type or what? Numeric. If I choose this one, already we have discussed in the last class, I can add the fields whose data type is what? Raw data type, existing, references to table types, references to classes and interfaces, all those things. Okay, so I'll go for can be an answer character type numeric. Done. Let me save, check for the syntax, activate this. So my structure is what created. So once a database structure is available, what you can do, I can reuse it in any number of other dictionary objects, any number of repository objects. As of now, I want to include that structure in my table. So what I'll do, if you remember, already in the basic programming, we already know the statement include type or include structure. We have used this keyword, include structure or what? Include type at the program level, followed by what? Structure name. And this structure at that time was a local structure, which is declared in the current program. Now what I'll do here, I'll go back to my table. Z645 underscore EMP is my table name. In this existing table, I want to include that structure. So what I can do, open your table, wherever you want to include. I can include it anywhere. I want to include at the end. So at the end, at the field level, use what? Dot include. At the field level, you have to use dot include. At the field level, you have to use dot include. At the data element level, provide your structure name. What is the structure name? ZJ details. ZJ details is your what? ZJ details your structure name. One second, please. Yeah, ZJ details is the structure name. I'll press enter. When I press enter, sorry, I guess slash here. I'll press enter. Done. So you can see that everybody showing it as what? STRU, which indicates what structure. So let me save it, check for the syntax error, activate this. Done. So what I have done to my existing table, I have included one dictionary structure. How do we include? Dot include followed by what? Structure name. Okay, so I want to check. Okay, this included structure contains what? Two fields, J date and what? J time. I want to check whether they are available in my table maintenance. So let me go to the table maintenance. Did I activate the table? Yes, it's activated. Now I'll go to the table maintenance. What is the T code I created? ZEM. So when I choose ZEM, then you can see here, it is not showing me those columns. It is not showing me those columns. Okay. Let me go to new entries. Here also it is not showing me that fields of my included structure. What are the fields of my included structure? J date and what? J time. So what is the problem again? Same thing. Okay. Already I told, whenever we add additional fields or modify existing fields or modify the labels, those changes will not reflect to what? Existing table maintenance. In order to reflect those changes, we need to recreate the table maintenance. So what I'll do, I'll go back to my table maintenance. I'll go to SC11. This is my table name. Click on change. I'll choose utilities, table maintenance generator, right? So I have to adjust this particular table maintenance. So in the last approach, what you have done, I clicked on the change button. It has displayed me all the relevant checkboxes. We selected all the checkboxes and said what? Continued. So here what I'll do, I'll do in a different way. I'll delete and regenerate. So I'll click on delete so that it will delete the existing table maintenance. So when I click on delete, do you want to delete everything? Yes, select everything and continue. So everything gets what? Deleted. The objects related to our table maintenance gets what? Generated. Done. Just go back once, activate the table. So what I'll do now, I need to regenerate the table maintenance. I'll choose utilities, table maintenance generator. Now we don't have delete button because it is deleted. So I have to what? Create. Before that, provide the necessary things. What are they? Function group is Z645F group. I'll go for maintenance type is a two-step only. I'll propose the screen numbers. Screen numbers are proposed. Click on what? Create. So it is going to regenerate the table maintenance. So the changes made to the table will not reflect the existing table maintenance. Now let me check it. Run the T code ZEM. When I run the T code ZEM, yeah, you can see here overview screen is not capable of showing all the screens. Remember, it will show only few fields. But if I click on new entries, you can see now it is showing me all the columns. So I'll give employee number 77. I'll give something employee name. Designation, I got the fixed values. Employee salary, I'll give. Okay, then I'll choose the date. Okay, I'll choose the date. I'll browse this. I'm getting the what? Calendar year. I'll choose the date. I'll choose the time also. Okay, let's do the same thing. Done. I'll click on what? Save. Data is set. So what is the employee number? 77. So you can observe now. So I'll go to SM30. Yeah, if I click on maintain, so 77. I cannot see all the columns. If you want to see the rest of the data for this record, choose the entry, click on details button. Choose the entry, click on details button. So it is showing me the rest of the, understood? This overview screen is not capable of showing what? All the fields. So just select the record and click on details. It will show the rest of the columns also. So what is the understanding? We understood how to create the structure, how to create the dictionary structure, and how to include the structure in the what dictionary objects. When I say dictionary objects, it can be database table or structure in this context. How do we include the structure? By using dot include followed by structure name. Then now here only I can do one small change. When I run the T code ZEM, I'll click on new entries. I'll give something 54. I'll give employee name. I'll give the designation. Okay, I'll give the salary. Okay, now I'm not entering the date and time. When I click on save button, okay, when I click on save button, automatically SAP should insert current to date and time for these two fields. Okay, whenever I click on the save button, SAP should automatically insert current date and time for these two fields. As of now, when I save it, what happened? Data is set with blank values maintained for what? Date and time. I don't want the blank values. I want the current server date and what? Server time to be assigned to these two fields. Understood? Understood. So I'm trying to maintain something. Based on that, some other thing has to be updated. So these things are possible by using what? By defining events as part of what? Table maintenance. By defining events as part of table maintenance. Understood? So how do we generate the events for table maintenance? Just here, very simple. So what is my agenda here? Whenever I insert a new record, automatically SAP should insert what? Date and time for those two fields. So go back to, you have to implement what? Events. So for that, I'll go to SC11. Okay, this is my table. You navigate to the table maintenance generator screen. Go to table maintenance generator, utilities table maintenance generator. In the table maintenance generator screen, what you have to do is, see here, in the table maintenance generator screen, choose the menu environment, modification events. Okay. Choose the menu. So what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to define events as part of table maintenance. Already we know how to handle events in selection screen, how to handle events in list processing screen. Like in list processing screen, we have seen at line selection, top of page, top of bearing line selection, end of page, start of selection. Okay. Similarly here also, as part of table level, if you want to define and implement any events, as part of table maintenance generator, choose the menu what? Environment modification events. Environment modification events. So when I say modification events, do not make changes to SAP data. It's an information message. Continue. Done. So we need to define and implement the events. How do we do it? See here. As of now, it is disabled here. Click on new entries. Click on new entries. Click on new entries. Done. Here it is asking time of event. T indicates what here? Something what? Table event or time of event we call it as. Right. So what you have to do now, when the event has to be triggered, when the event has to be triggered, whenever you're trying to create a new record, it should trigger the event. Okay. Just like when you click on the selection skin button, what is the event triggered? At selection skin. When you press F4 in the selection screen input field, what is the event triggered? At selection screen on value request. Similarly, it is asking which event you want to handle. So when I browse this, they are the different events supported at what? Table level. They are the different events supported at table level. Understood? Right? So one of the event you can see, we are 05. What is this? Creating a new entry. So what is my requirement? Whenever I create a new entry, automatically date and time should be inserted for those two columns. So I feel the appropriate event is at 05. I cannot choose whatever I want. It should be appropriate for your requirement. What is my requirement here? Whenever I create a new entry, it should insert the data. So I'll choose what? 05, which indicates what? Creating a new entry. And how do we write the logic for that event inside subroutine? So it is asking form routine. So you can give any subroutine name. I'll give the subroutine name as, one second. I'll give the subroutine name as, right? So I'll give the subroutine name as something, create something, or yeah, create date and time. Create date time is my subroutine name. Any user defined name, any name you can give. Okay, so choose what? The table event. What is the table event I've chosen here? 05, which indicates what? Creating a new entry. Associate a subroutine for that particular event, and you have to press enter. When you press enter, this column will be enabled. Editor column will be enabled. You need to click on this button and write the logic for your subroutine. Okay, so just press enter. After proposing the subroutine name, press enter. Yes, the button is enabled. Click on this button to write the logic for the subroutine. Click on the button, editor button. When I click on that, it is asking, this is a subroutine. Where do you want to create the subroutine? So it is saying that it is going to create a new include program. So let it create what? New include program for defining the subroutine. Let me choose the first entry. Click on continue. Okay, in the program so and so, an include statement will be inserted. Continue. So it is going to open an include where I need to define the subroutine logic. Right, so it has opened me a include program. So how do we define the subroutine? Already we know. What is that? Form. What is the subroutine name I give? Create date time. Create date time. Form and what? End form. Right, form and end form. You have to write the logic. So what is my requirement? I need to insert the data for these two fields, na? J date and what? J time, which are part of my table. Na? How do we access the structure field? Structure name, hyphen field name. Similarly, table fields also will access by using what? Table name, hyphen field name. Understood? Whenever we include the structure, those structure fields becomes part of what? Table. So here I'll say, Z645 underscore EMB hyphen what? J date equal to, already we know the system field what? Psi datum. Then Z645 underscore EMB hyphen what? J time equal to what? Psi UJIT. Psi UJIT. Okay, I'm assigning date and time for those two fields. Right, let me save it. Check for the syntax error. No errors. Activate this. Done, it is activated. So let me put a breakpoint just to check when this event is getting triggered. So I'll put the cursor here, I'll put the breakpoint. I'm putting the breakpoint. The position of the breakpoint cannot be drawn, it is not recognizing. So I'll use the keyword what? Breakpoint. Save it, check for the syntax error, active errors. Understood? I'm using the breakpoint keyword. It is not allowing me to set the breakpoint there. So I'm using the keyword breakpoint. So my include is what activated. Simple logic. Understood? So how do we write the logic for that event as part of a subroutine? Done. So I'll go back. Just save it once. It is saved. Go back. Just save it. Go back. Save everything. Go back. Save it. Activate this. Then it is activated. Okay. So let me quickly maintain. I'll go to ZEM. Done. I'll click on new entries. I'll give the employee number something 79. I'll give the employee name. Employee designation, I'll give something manager. Salary, I'll give something. Then I'll click on save button. So when I click on save button, SAP will trigger that end, what event? What is that event? 05, creating a new entry. So when I click on save button, it has to call that subroutine, our subroutine. Let me check. When I click on the save button, I may get a runtime error. I clicked on the save button. The program is getting terminated. Yeah, I got a runtime error. What is the error? ABAP programming error, perform not found. Call to a non-existing external subroutine. The current ABAP program had to return because it has come across a statement that unfortunately cannot be executed. So what is the error I'm getting here? See, the reason for the exception is the program so-and-so is trying to execute an external perform. What is that subroutine name? Create date and time. This routine does not exist, however. This routine does not exist, however. So it is saying that SAP is trying to call this subroutine, but it is saying that this subroutine is not existing. Where you have defined that subroutine in the include, na? So what you have to do is whenever we handle or whenever we implement events as part of table level, I repeat, whenever we implement events as as part of table level, you need to activate your function group so that all the objects get adjusted. So if you go to object navigator, if you go to SCAT, okay, so this is my function groups. You can see all dependent objects are there. If you go to the subroutines also, you'll have many subroutines here. We have many subroutines. What is our subroutine? Create date and time. So somewhere it will be there. Yeah, create date and time. If I double click on this, this subroutine is available in one of the include. So I repeat once again, whenever we generate, whenever we handle events at what table level, you need to activate your function group once. You need to activate your function group once so that all the dependent objects get adjusted. So I'll right click on the function group and say what? Activate. Done. Function group is what activated. Now you can go and maintain your table. So the thumb rule is whenever you implement any events at table level, after that you activate your function group. So now come to the T code ZEM. Okay, I'll click on new entries. I'll give the employee number. I'll give the employee name. Then I'll give designation. I'll give some salary. I'll click on what? Save button. When I click on save button, yeah, you can see here it is going to the debugging, means that event got triggered, and whenever that event is triggered, control will go to our subroutine because that is the subroutine we have associated as part of our event. Okay, as part of our event. Done. Right. So I can go to desktop one or desktop three. Done. So I can see here these are my two table fields. As of nothing is there. When I say F5, I got the date and what time. effect, what happened? Automatically it is inserted what? Date and time for the stool field. So what is the problem? That include was not activated. So what you have to do is, the thumb rule is, whenever we implement, please mute your speakers, Vamshi. So whenever we implement events at a table level, okay, you need to activate your function group so that the table gets what? The function group gets what? Adjusted. All the dependent objects gets adjusted. Okay, so what we have done so far is we have seen how to create the tables. Hello. If we have done any additional screen changes manually, for example, disabling occupants to okay for the two screen, now we'll then table maintenance logic. This screen logic will be deleted or will exist. It will exist, so you need to activate the function group. When you activate the function group, it gets what? Adjusted. Understood? So whenever you do any changes, screen changes also, you must activate your function group so that all the dependent objects also gets what? Adjusted. Okay, so what you have done here so far, we have created the table by using what? Direct data types. We have seen the what? Limitations. We have seen the limitations of what? Creating the table by using direct data types. So then what you have done, and here only we have seen generating what? Table maintenance. Okay, we have seen how to generate the table maintenance, and here I think we followed what? One step. Okay, then what we have done, we have created the tables by using what? Data elements and what? Domains. Then what you have done, we have generated the table maintenance using what? Two steps. Okay, then what you have done, we have changed the label. We have changed the label at what? Data element level. And that change is not reflecting my table maintenance. So what you have done, the existing table maintenance we have modified, we have clicked on our change button and we have regenerated. Then what you have done, we have seen how to create what? Dictionary structure. Then we have seen what? How to include a dictionary structure in what? Database tables by using what? Dot include. Then what you have done, we have generated what? We have seen how to implement events at what? Table level. Okay, how do we implement events at table level? In the form of what? Subroutines. We'll write the business logic inside what? Subroutines. So what happened here? We got the runtime error when you are maintaining the what? Table. So what is the reason? Whenever we implement the event, implementing the event means you are writing some code. Where that code will exist? In the include program. So that include needs to be activated. So for that, what you have to do? You need to activate your function group. Okay, so the thumb rule is, whenever we do any changes in my table level, table maintenance, that is when you implement the events or when you write any screen changes logic, okay, we must activate the function group. Then only the dependent objects gets what? Adjusted. Then only the dependent object gets adjusted. Vamshi, is it clear? what you have written, if we have done any additional screen changes manually, okay, disabling, okay, done for the two screens. Now, while regenerating the TMG, deleting the TMG event, those screen logic event will be exist. No, it will exist. It will exist. If you have done any additional screen changes manually, okay, while regenerating the table events, no, it will exist. The code will remain. Code will remain, Vamshi. It will not be deleted. Done. So related to this table only, we have many concepts like currency and what, quantity fields. Okay, currency and quantity fields. We have indexing at table level. We have buffering at what table level. Okay, and we have types of what database level. So all these things we'll discuss in the coming sessions. Okay, so far we have seen only table and what dictionary structures, and we have seen data elements and what domains. So we'll continue the rest of the part from tomorrow. Any questions for today, please ask me. No questions? Fine then. So I'll wind off. We'll continue tomorrow with the rest of the dictionary objects.
This conference will now be recorded.
Syed, you have any questions? Yes, we can. We'll discuss it. Yeah, as part of the course, we'll discuss it. How to create authorization object, we'll see. I'll show you how to create an authorization object and how to assign it to the users. Yes, I'll discuss it, Srikant. Syed, Oops class, no. Oops class, no, I kept it old again, Syed, because no one is responding properly. So I don't want to start for five to six participants. Minimum 10 only I would need to start. So let them come back to me, then only I'll start. So that Oops class is not yet started, okay? So once it is restarted, I'll let you know. And authorization object also, we'll see Srikant. Going forward, we'll see that. Chalo. So I'm winding off. We'll continue tomorrow.